eSportBets.com – уникальное место для настоящего геймера. Только здесь возможны ставки на киберспортивные события. Ты знаешь толк в самых популярных играх и готов рисковать? Смотри регулярные трансляции и зарабатывай реальные деньги. eSportBets.com – живой азарт и холодный расчет.
And we are back once again. Sorry about a bit of a pause there. Just trying to figure out the IP for the upcoming game, which is going to be between virtus.pro and NaVi. Definitely going to be a really, really sick game coming up. And we're just waiting for the right IP. Then we should be good to go. So welcome to Room on Fire. Hope you guys are excited for this one. It's going to be just an exceptional game coming up here, especially because Vendetta, we're going to be on Mirage.
Really?
Yeah.
Now, not too shabby.
A Mirage is one of the best maps for, well, probably the best map for NaVi, but also one of the best maps for virtus.pro. So that's why it's very interesting that we've come up with this particular map. Both teams really strong on it, and I imagine we'll have one hell of a match, but there's a lot of unknowns right now, I feel like. First of all, NaVi seem to be a little bit inconsistent, at least from what we've seen today. They almost lost that game to Penta, which is the team that was previously called Berserk with Asmo and Crystal and everything of Solik and everyone else in it. And on the other hand, virtus.pro, they've just come back from a vacation. I mean, they've been not playing that much in the past couple of weeks here. So, I mean, how much can we really know about this game, do you think?
Yeah, that's a good question. I'm actually not really sure how to go on about that. Well, correct me if I'm wrong, but BP are going to G3.
Yes, I'm pretty sure they are.
Yeah.
Like 99.99% sure.
Yeah, well, okay, I'm just going to put you on the spot. You should know because you're going there.
I should definitely know. Yeah. Yeah, I am going. Yeah, yeah. I should know, and I'm sure they're going, actually, so.
Yeah, okay. Even though they're coming back from a vacation, as you pointed out, this is one of the best maps VP have in their map pool. Same thing goes for another. I don't know. I think this is a pretty much impossible to call game in terms of who's going to come out ahead. I guess you might want to give the upper hand to NaVi since they have been playing quite a bit actually in the past few weeks.
Yeah, I really can't tell. I'm really pressed to try and figure out who's going to win this. I've based on NaVi's weird style the past couple of days, I'm actually going to say I think virtus.pro will win this.
Really?
Yeah.
Even though it's Mirage, because, I mean, obviously, LC beat NaVi, which is, I guess, somewhat unexpected, or it was unexpected for most people.
Yeah. Yeah, well, yeah, I would say
Even though, you know, people figured LC might have a shot on a really good day, right?
Yeah, if anyone tries to claim that they expected LC to win, they're probably lying, put it like that.
I'm going to claim it either way, because I play with the guys, so I'm gonna claim insider knowledge. But in any case, I think even though NaVi lost to LC, 2 days ago, they completely demolished them on Mirage.
Yeah,
I mean, utterly demolished them. So even though NaVi might have had, I don't know, an off day. Actually, I don't want to take anything away from LC. But even though NaVi weren't able to win versus LC, they still played that well on Mirage, and I think that has to kind of play into their advantage, even if they're going up a team like VP.
It could be. Oh, you weren't even here for the LC games. You're right. You were away with some family. Have you been watching that game since? I guess you haven't had much time.
I actually watched. I did that right after we'd done or finishing up the last EMS games last night.
So the thing that's really interesting is, I would say the game that we just saw between
Penta
and NaVi, that was interesting because it came a lot down to, you know, headshots. I think NaVi were playing a little bit worse than they normally would, and they seemed to make some mistakes early on. Not to try and steal anything away from Penta, they had a really good Counter-Strike game, but NaVi definitely weren't on full form. I would say the game against between LC and NaVi, I really, really think the Norwegians actually just played some really sick basic Counter-Strike. I didn't feel in that game like NaVi were just like not functioning at all. I just felt like they just had really good strats, really good simple strats.
Yeah, And obviously they're really good individual players, and I've always been of that, I guess, perception that if those guys hit their shots in our own point and actually playing as a unit, which was kind of an issue for them earlier on before they started playing with PRB, they could definitely, you know, bring it to pretty much any team. So yeah, it was really fun to see them actually, you know, putting the pieces together, and that's apparently what they did versus NaVi, because you don't beat NaVi unless you're doing something right.
Yeah, no, definitely not. But I think there are different ways you can beat like a top team. I would have been different for me if, let's say, Rain had just been carrying, like Rain drops, you know, 35-5 scoreline, and he just, you know, everything he does works. Then I would have said, yeah, whatever, you know, it's cool that that happened, but I wouldn't give too much credit to LC as a whole if that happened. I would just say, right,
yeah,
what are the chances that Rain will ever in his life do that again? Probably none. So yeah, so that's the last time we'll ever see this.
But yeah, it'd be more like, well, Rain races his stock, but LC as a team doesn't.
Yeah, exactly.
For you. Yeah.
Exactly. And I think because of the way they won, I actually don't think that's the case at all. I think it's obviously going to be much tougher for them to do a similar thing on land because of the pressure on land and how much of a different environment it is and all that stuff. But I don't think this is just like a one-time performance from them at all.
Hey, well, we hope not, at least. It's always fun to see new teams emerging onto the scene and kind of taking everyone on, you know,
yeah,
everyone by surprise and riding that wave of confidence and momentum. And they kind of did that earlier as well when they were playing under H2K during the time where they won Assembly. And they actually had a couple of weeks where they had really solid results, even though it didn't necessarily always end with a win. They had some really good showings until it started going downhill again, but hopefully this time they're here to stay.
Be nice if they could keep up like this. And I mean, Rain, Semler was warning us that you had been talking good stuff about Rain, and he definitely delivered in some sick rounds. But right here, we're obviously waiting for NaVi and virtus.pro. Both teams a little bit delayed getting into this game here. Hopefully not going to be a big deal, but obviously we want to get the show on the road here. So if you're just joining us, then welcome to Room on Fire. This is the SLTV Star Series Season 10. And Guardian is spamming. Did NaVi lose Sing Sing?
Sing Sing. That's from Sing Sing stream. Obviously, as you know, because you've played with Guardian, but Guardian is a big Dota fan, Dota enthusiast, and I think his favorite player is Sing Sing, because if you look at his avatar on Steam, it's actually a picture of Sing Sing. Sing Sing has a way with words whenever he's streaming. So usually, you know, you lose first blood and Sing Sing goes, "Oh, we fucking lost." Well, not really with that accent, but you know.
I haven't heard that. Why have I not heard that?
It's brilliant. Sing Sing is really fun to watch, actually. So if you're into Dota, you should definitely check his stream out.
I might go and do that. I'm just going to check the admin chat to see if they know why the teams are delayed, so we can maybe get on the way. So sorry about the lack of audio on the stream here. We're just going to come back any second when I tap back in. Let's just see.
Well, slowly but certainly, people are connecting. Or I mean, we're 7 out of 10, so...
Yeah, all right. So there's no news either. I think they're just a little bit late. Maybe a little bit lazy. I guess it's the vacation still sticking in here for virtus.pro. I mean, so we've seen NaVi in play here, and I guess they showed us that... I think to the top fraggers in the last game was Seized, Guardian, and Edward were sort of the three people really standing out, and Starix and Seuss a little bit behind, which is actually not uncommon. They weren't playing badly, Starix and Seuss. They were just doing what I think they're meant to do in this team, basically be the guys with experience and the guys making the calls, and then, you know, just supporting everywhere else. So that's all right, really. On virtus.pro's side, I mean, who would you say are the people to watch for on the Polish side?
Pasha definitely being the number one threat, I think, for NaVi to watch out for. Other than that, I think it kind of rotates between Bialy and Snacks, actually. I'm not really sure who I'd pick out if I were to just single out one person, but I think those two are the ones who have to step up in addition to Pasha if they're going to overcome NaVi.
Yeah, definitely. I think, just like a personal thing, I guess between the two, recently at least, I think Snacks has got maybe like an inch or two above Bialy, but it is close. I mean, and they are the two sort of new additions to the team. We can't really call them new because I guess they've been playing with them for a while now, but compared to how long the other three have been together, they are kind of new. I guess they'll actually be new forever, right? I mean, they'll never be able to make out.
Yeah, as long as they play with that core of those three players, they're always going to be the new guys forever. Even 5 years from now, if they're still playing, they're going to be the new guys. And I think you have to play a really long time not to be the new guy in CS. I mean, we still talk about Tusken as a new map in CS, even though it's not even in CSGO. So I guess that's kind of a silly statement, but...
No, but I do think of it that way as well.
Yeah,
it's strange.
Exactly. It's been out since, what, 2007, I want to say? Something to that effect. So, you know, quite a few years. And to any other community, that would be mammoth age. But to us, that's still new and kind of scary.
Yeah, that's just how the community is, I suppose. Which is all right. Change is not always well received here. I mean, just look at Overpass and the Cobble.
Well, sometimes it is justified to, I guess, take the back of the community. Obviously, we should have a, maybe have a bit of a better way of going about it than just going, I guess, like on a give dire tide kind of rampage. But yeah, sometimes it's warranted, sometimes it's not.
Well, we're about to find out here if NaVi and virtus.pro can still remember how to play here on Mirage. It's the SLTV Starseries Season 10. Welcome to the show, everyone. We've got a great game in our hands here. This is Room on Fire. Remember to follow and subscribe to the channel and just enjoy the game here. I'm Anders, with me is Vendetta, of course. Semler taking a bit of a break this evening, which is all right. We've had a pretty long evening, all of us, so he had some other clans as well, so that's all good in the hood. Now, Bayali is going to be the last man standing, and... Yep, they're going to switch to the CT side, which is the slightly more favored side here in Mirage. So not a big surprise, but I don't think it's going to make a big deal. I think the pistol rounds are going to be what really settles this.
Yeah, so actually kind of a similar story to what we saw in the first game, where the pistol rounds actually played a huge part in favor of NaVi.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. Edward going to be throwing a bit of a decoy into the middle. I guess that's all right. Maybe just... It's not really going to make of a difference here. I don't know. I think sometimes those decoys can be really useful, but I think sometimes they're just for fun.
Yeah, sometimes you just want to spend $50 on something silly, so they buy a decoy.
Exactly.
Yeah, and it seems like we're going to see the pretty much patented NaVi pistol. Garden's going to smoke off, and it's going to be a pretty standard A-push with Starks being the backstabber.
Yeah, smoke lands right here, forcing Bayali to either jump up on the box or try and wait for the smoke to disappear, basically. Snacks down here. Oh, okay. What a great shot. Now Bayali, now Pasher as well. Starix and Guardian are the only two left alive right here, and Snacks is going to pick up one more kill, and that was a devastating headshot. The first one was so fast. That was a thing of beauty.
It really was. And I actually think that was a slight deviation from what NaVi have done earlier. If I'm not completely mistaken, I think they normally do that to start with two smokes. So they were able to smoke off the stairs as well. And I think that would have benefited them greatly in that scenario right there. But VP get off to a good start. So I guess the vacation nerves or the vacation aim is not a thing for the Polish players.
Apparently not, and they pick up two P90s here and also an MP7, so they're just using all the dirty submachine guns here, and actually none of them are going to pick up a kill. It's going to be Pasher and Snags, and I guess finally got the one here with the P90, so it was worth something. NaVi didn't even get a bomb plant, but they are still going to be buying. Ven, how do you feel about this?
I actually think it's okay, because I think they are aware of the fact that Neo, for instance, is one of the players who actually buys the MP7 on a consistent basis, and they also heard Bialy obviously getting a frag with a P90, has a P90, and Taz as well. So with these machine guns, they're going to be better equipped, really, than VP, so they could definitely punish the Polish guys with this early buy, and it might not be expected from NaVi.
Yeah, maybe they won't realize, although I think they're putting some shots in every once in a while. So
eventually the element of surprise is going to be gone. Actually, I think Seuss has tagged up Snacks already, so I am assuming they expect a full buy from this point on. I guess the big issue right now is that NaVi have lost the element of surprise, and they don't really have that much nades to work with. It's only Guardian who has a smoke.
And the Poles aren't really giving them much of an opening. I mean, Taz here, if they can pick him off when he's jumping, which would certainly be really sick, that's the best chance they have. He's going to call for backup straight away. And P90 here, if they don't kill him straight away, he can definitely take out a lot of players. It's not that bad against armor. It's not the best, but it's good enough. Taz going to pick up one kill. Neo goes down. And this is a great entrance coming in. Starix and Guardian picking up the opening. And it's going to be another one for Seuss. Bialy and Snag should probably not go for this retake.
They really shouldn't. They should just run with the tails between their legs right now. Yeah. It seems like they really want to punish the fact that NaVi spend absolutely every cent they had on that round and get some exit kills. And I'm not really sure I agree with that, because NaVi have already gotten the bomb down, so they're going to have enough money to buy regardless the upcoming round.
Bialy going to peek in there, take down Seuss, pick up the AK, and virtus.pro making the most, I think, of a lost situation and just trying to get exit kills. But in the middle here, Edward's ready and waiting, and Snags probably shouldn't have lived through that, but he does, and that's going to be the round here. Two people surviving for either team, and NaVi's risk, it paid off, so you were right, Vendetta. I mean, it's a bit of a calculated risk, but it actually works out well.
Yeah, it worked out really well from NaVi. I think it's a bit unfortunate that Neo missed his smoke into AAPS there. I think that could have helped virtus.pro quite a bit. Also, Pasha, who went for the manly play there, basically bomb-rushing through smoke to get into Forest. By the bencher at the back of B site, and didn't quite make it in time. But I think if he gets into position right there, he could shut down at least two or three NaVi players.
Yeah, now we're into the fourth round, and Neo is playing like someone who wants to go up even further towards the middle, where Edward is hanging around. He's kind of alone if he does, and he's going to be waiting right here. Can actually look through the edge of the smoke, be a really big opening, and just does some damage. Actually, a lot of damage to Edward, and grenade follow-up. Edward is going to fall back, doesn't want to get tagged, but that's really simple and effective play coming out from Neo, I think, early on here.
Yeah, and also what's really cool, seeing how they bought mainly SMGs in the after winning the pistol round, they still have money to get a really good buy, actually, considering they lost the previous round. So I think this is a huge round for NaVi. If they lose this one and don't get a bomb plant, they're completely screwed over, while virtus.pro are going to have a really nice time and a good ability or good opportunity to actually build up a solid bank.
Yeah. Oh, a fake over at the 8 bomb site, and they are buying it hook, line, and sinker. Look how far away Neo is running. It's just Taz alone, and there are three people coming with an M4A1. This is really hard. He's going to have to hit almost nothing but headshots if he wants to kill all of them. There's the one. Second one is going to be Guardian, and he doesn't play around. And then over at the ramp here, I really want Seize to not move anywhere. I just want him to stay and backstab them, because this is really, really great for NaVi at the moment. Especially with a kill like that. Flashbang rains in towards the kitchen. Now Guardian spots one right here. He's going to go down, and they lose the bomb site anyway. Oh, I thought that was such a good position for them. Now Seast is walking up behind, just wants to get a kill. He's going to pick down Pasha, but he can't stop the defuse, and he's going to get one more. That's a triple. Goes for the last one and gets a quad kill. Seized. What is happening? I mean, that was insane, but it wasn't enough.
It really wasn't, and I agree with you. That was a really nice position for NaVi to be in. Unfortunately, I think it was Edward who was down to 8 HP by the time that retake happened, so they couldn't buy enough time for Seuss to comfortably sneak behind the rest of VP, but it still cost them a lot. You can see the buy on... Well, virtus.pro are basically broke, and they have no nades, really, to speak of. They have two smokes, and that's it.
Two smokes, and... I don't know. I mean, they have the... They have the AWP on Neo, which is over here by the B bomb site, and I think I really like that. I mean, this is something that I've been advocating for a long time, is trying to use the AWP more in B than I would in middle, because I think it's not that it's banned in middle, it's just that holding B is really difficult without it. And look how far away Neo can look. If they were coming, he'd spot them so early and pretty get a kill. But in the B bomb site, there's even more trouble right now, as Bialy's already gone down. Pasha shooting through, very nearly takes down Seuss. It's going to be Snacks to get a kill finally, and Pasha with a re-peek is going to be going down, and I think virtus.pro need to probably just give up on this bomb site here. It's a 2-on-3. The bomb is going to go down, and as you said, they have almost no grenades, and they don't have a kit either.
Yeah, not having a kit in this situation is basically game set and match. I don't really see why any reason for virtus.pro to hang around.
Yeah, Neo can definitely go for an extra kill, but especially if Taz is going to help him out. Taz runs the other way. I wish they would have stuck together to try and look for some exits, but yeah, you just have so little time, and because of the architecture of this A bomb site, there's just too many places for you to check. You can't realistically go and check every corner, and especially not if you expect to have everyone alive at the end of it. So doesn't really work out so well.
And virtus.pro managed to hang on with the two weapons, still not able to being to or still not being able to buy up in the upcoming round. But we've seen when teams save a couple of weapons, they can make a lot of things work actually with limited options. And I actually like the fact that Neo is going mid this round with the AWP, because I think they have to get a pick pretty early on.
Let's see if they're going to be able to. Snacks up here in the apartments with the P2K, not really going to be able to do anything now that he got spotted. Still a good idea, I mean, this is headshot range with the P2K if someone was going to go for him. And now Bionelli close to the ramp at A bombsite with a Mag 7, puts a shot right in the back of Seized and brings him down to 4 HP, which is not enough for a kill, and Snacks is going to go down as well. So I like the attempt here from virtus.pro, but as you said, you're saving the orb at the very least here is going to be a priority now that they're in a 3-on-4, a 5 here. I think that's what they need to do.
Yeah, Neo and Taz just needs to get as far away from the situation as possible, and Pasha is more or less free to do whatever he wants at this point. It doesn't really hurt VP at all if he loses that Seized at 75, and if he manages to pick up a kill on perhaps Seized, who's only on 4 HP in T-spawn, that would be big for them, especially if he can get the AK.
Especially if they can get that. I mean, they're on the more favored side here, and virtus.pro's economy is actually very much broken. Snacks, Bionelli, and Neo, sorry, Snacks, Bionelli, and Taz are all on $0, and everyone else doesn't have a lot either, so anything that they can scavenge and use for the upcoming round is going to be worth its weight in gold. It's not happening right now. It's going to be still the AWP and the M4, which can be enough, but it has to be in the right spot. I mean, I guess that's what we learned last round is NaVi managed to pick the site where there was almost no equipment at all, and that won them the round.
Yeah. And NaVi was smart. I assume they were anticipating Neo to go mid with the AWP, and that's kind of why they left the entire area to itself. And it worked out nicely for them. This time around, Bialy gets picked up early on, and now it's going to be really hard for VP to actually find anything. But as I say that, Taz is on a mission up in mid.
Yeah, well, they get Guardian killed, but I guess the good thing about what Bialy did up in the apartments this time is he spotted a couple of people, so that now that sort of forces NaVi to change whatever they were doing, because you can kind of see on the virtus.pro side that they're sort of shuffling Taz around to try and see if he can find the right bomb site, and Neo's staying put here. So I kind of like this idea of having Taz be the mobile player and then Neo be the one who stays put. Unfortunately, they're rotating the wrong way here. Once again, NaVi faking it out, and Snags 5-7 in hand, sick headshot. But I'm not sure it's quite enough. Taz looking for the kill. It might actually be enough. They're in a 2-on-3 right now. Edward looking for the kill in kitchen. Going to be walking around here. Taz goes down now. A 2-on-2. Pasha can't find the kill. They're both so low. Seized on 9. Edward on 33. 1 is going to go down and Seized. I don't think he can do this anymore. They do have a kit on Neo as well. He's going to be going down. And this should be an easy defuse. Yeah, no problem at all. So that is... there it is, and that's actually Snags, I think, that really, if he doesn't get that kill, I'm not sure that NaVi aren't just going to win the round straight away.
Yeah, we might actually see NaVi or virtus.pro just opt to save their rifles again if Snags doesn't get that kill. But yeah, really solid job by VP. I think Taz opening Frag and Guardian really did a lot for them, because it forced NaVi into an awkward rotation, as well as VP gained so much map control and information as to what was going on for on the side of NaVi, and them having the luxury of putting Neo alone on the A bombsite was really, really helpful as well.
And he got the pick off on the one guy who was faking it. So we've seen that a couple of times from NaVi already. It seems just the willingness to try and go for some pretty elaborate fakes, which is kind of cool. I won't say that's too much their usual style. I think their usual style is just slow, but not necessarily including fakes.
Yeah, we don't see too many fakes really, especially on Mirage. And oftentimes we'll see them be pretty obvious about where they want to go and maybe leave Starks behind around the middle slash connector area and work with everyone else towards a certain site and leave it at that. But yeah, I guess it's nice to see that now we are actually playing with different styles as well, so they have more options.
And this time they're going to have to try and see if they can defend this bombsite. Bialy's the only one inside here. Snacks unscopes at the wrong time, and now Bastia's going to go down. Snacks falls next. Edward and Seized with great openings and a flawless round so far from NaVi. How did this happen? Those smokes were somehow just way too effective.
They were perfect, and they actually opted to not smoke off jungle, which is a bit of a unusual decision from Na'Vi. Instead, they opted to throw a ton of smokes towards that A side and basically shut Neo out completely and whoever initially was under shadows. And it worked out great for them because they were so fast at actually committing to that take and getting control over connector and the jungle area that they were free to get the bomb down and basically control whatever would happen on that A bomb site.
Well, 4-4, and we're going to be in the 9th round, then. I mean, when Na'Vi are able to do stuff like that, I guess virtus.pro didn't have the best setup to hold that kind of push with having Bialy on the shadows here and then Snacks opening from connector. That's kind of a light defense on A. But even then, they were a little bit... I mean, those smokes just meant that Na'Vi were actually all the way in the bomb site, I think, before... They were all the way over by connector before anything really happened. There it is. Taz goes down at B, and once again, virtus.pro's defense is just not where it's supposed to be. I mean, they're ecoing here, but Na'Vi are really selecting the right bomb sites at the right times.
Yeah, they really are. And I think they felt a tad more safe than what they did in the previous... Or versus the previous eco ramp from virtus.pro. And they kind of just went as a big clump with a ton of AKs and mauled over the Polish side. But yeah, right now it's all about getting exit frags for VP, and they can't really hope for anything more. You can see Snacks is kind of lurking around in underpass, hoping that someone is going to hunt after them.
He really wants to pick off somebody, but they're not even going to go for it. They are playing it safely and making sure they just have as much money as they can. And they actually don't. Now they have a lot more, but before this round, they were actually not that high up on the economy. So I guess Na'Vi are just playing a very, very different game. And I mean, if you compare how Na'Vi are playing right here then to how they're playing on Dust 2, it's definitely a striking difference, I would say.
Yeah, I think it definitely is. And it's not that surprising either, because I think it's safe to say that Mirage is their best map, and I think it shows. I think it's pretty evident that they feel a lot more comfortable in everything they do on a map like this. It's also obviously the fact that this has been a pretty back and forth game. I think the most rounds in a row that we've seen so far is 2 rounds in a row, and both of them have been from Na'Vi.
Yeah.
So like the money situation is all over the place, and I think Na'Vi have decided like now it's time to stabilize and actually, well, try to play cool for a while.
And they went for that gamble earlier on in the 3rd round where it really worked out for them. They just had some Galils and it was enough to destroy the economy of virtus.pro, and it's really not recovered since. They've had such a tough time, the Poles, bringing it back on track, because they've been hitting their shots, but they haven't had a lot of money to work with. And see if Na'Vi can actually take this A bomb site again. It feels like it's going to be an A push with the bomb over at the ramp here. And 45 seconds left. Characteristically slow from Na'Vi. Edward goes down. It's a great pickup from Neo. Going to look for a second one here. Seuss won't fall, but he's going to fall right back into Taz, who will pick up that kill easily. So now it comes down to Bialy inside this A bomb site. He has to stay alive or come up big, and not going to happen yet. Pasha goes down. So from a good position to a very bad one. Now Taz alone, 1-on-3, and I'm pretty sure they even heard him jumping through. I think Starix knows exactly where he is. Turns around, gets the kill, and it's going to be 6-4 in favor of Na'Vi on the less favored side here.
Yeah, well-executed round from Na'Vi. Nothing more to say really about that. And it really seems like virtus.pro are not quite up to pace when it comes to making the rotations they need, because it seems like whenever Na'Vi pushes site, virtus.pro are off by one man. They always have like one man less than what they should have to really hold off a push that Na'Vi are throwing at them.
It's definitely what it feels like. Oh, Guardian, Starix, and then Pasha with a good grenade coming in here. Really, really important round for virtus.pro. If they can pick up this round from an eco, that would be a huge thing for them right here. Taz and Neo mixing up the names right here. Taz is the only one left now, going for the kill. Seized, just will not fall. He's down to 24 health. He's picking up a triple kill, but that was a very close round. For once, virtus.pro were actually in the right place at the right time. Unfortunately, they just didn't have rifles that time.
Yeah, if that was a buy round, that would probably have been a round for VP. I think that, yeah, they were definitely in the right positions to counter whatever Na'Vi threw at them at that point. But unfortunately for them, the money situation is not in their favor.
Definitely not. As you said, it's been, in the beginning, no more than 2 rounds stringed together from everyone, but now it's 4 in a row for Na'Vi, and a lot of those, or at least some of those, have been eco rounds from virtus.pro, where they just haven't been able to really pick it up. Big question is if that's going to change now. If Virtus Pro can secure and win 4 rounds in a row and make it 8-7, I guess they are still going to be in the game. I mean, 8-7 is not a completely devastating score for the CT side, but obviously NaVi already have a really good half on their hands.
Yeah, they really do. And the fact is that VP's economy is so shaky at this point that whenever they lose a round, they're going to have to eco right after. And that leaves, obviously, a huge opportunity for NaVi to basically run away with this game. So even though it's been very close up till this point, NaVi could fully possible end up winning the first half 11-4.
That would be really scary. Good pickup from Pasha. AWP up on the box in that A-bomb site. And now they have the full force here at the A-bomb site. Snag's going to take down Starix. It's a 3-on-4, and this seems to be working out. Neo coming in for connector. Going to get taken down by Edward. It's going the wrong way once again by Ali Falls, and it's not working. NaVi, even when they're a man down, they just mow right through and pick off players left and right. Taz, he's going to go for the 1-on-3 retake here. Gets flashed as well, and they know exactly where he is. And he's going to go down before that flash even fades. Good headshot coming in from Edward, and a double kill from him as well. 8-4, moving into the 13th round, and I imagine Virtus Pro is going to force it up anyway here. Even with this bad economy, I mean...
Yeah, at a certain point, you kind of have to say it's now or never. And apparently, they do a bit of a wonky buy. Pasha picks up a scout. So this is an eco, but they're still investing some into it. And that, I think that's a mixture of them wanting and needing rounds and not really wanting to give it away too easy for NaVi.
Well, maybe not. I guess it could be better than having double ecos in the middle of this whole mess, but I kind of wish they would have gone for Famasus and fought for a 8-7 scoreline, because as you said, I mean, 11-4 is really not the score they're looking for. And at this point, I mean, NaVi are going to have so much money. They already do have so much money. 16,000 on Guardian. They're never going to be able.
Yeah, they're not going to be able to break NaVi for the rest of the half. And I would like to see them try something more similar to what they did earlier on, which when we saw Taz pushing aggressively up in middle, because we know that NaVi play a notoriously passive style, just in general, and especially on Mirage. So if VP are able to kind of find out, basically, what kind of holes there are in the NaVi setups, then they'll be able to push out aggressively, gain a ton of information, and get those stacks towards the right bomb sites. And I think they need that, because they haven't really been able to fight off NaVi with their vanilla setups up to this point.
Not exactly. I kind of wish they would throw in some aggression then, Virtus Pro. Like, they've been doing it in the A apartments, but why not in the middle then? That's a really common CT side strat as well. And they have Pasha who can hold the window. They can put somebody up there. I mean, Snacks or Taz just moving in, but they are doing much the same. I mean, this time they have a forward push towards ramp, but NaVi, again, are picking the right bomb side all the time. The only one defending this B bomb site right now is Taz, and I guess Neo is coming into help out. But if Taz goes down, I don't see a scenario in which Neo is going to be able to hold this.
MVP are way too split up right now, and Sue's just hanging up in mid, just waiting for people to rotate.
Taz goes down. Now Neo has to kill a lot of people here. Gonna miss the shot on Seized and go down. Good repeat coming out from the Russian player here. NaVi are about to take a 10th round. Guardian will pick up a kill and doesn't even go down there. Now he's re-peeking against Pasha, who's running in right here. Misses the shot, but it's still bombed down and a 2-on-3. And things are looking really good for NaVi. They have Edward alive. Rest are kind of low. Pasha goes down. Now it's all on Snags here. And that bomb is so far ticked already. I really don't see any way he can do this. Even though it sounds painful, he's gonna have to try and run away and save this rifle in the 14th round.
Yeah, does pick up 2 exit frags though, so I guess that's something to cheer for if you're VP. But yeah, right now they need to do something different, because NaVi are basically forcing their will on VP. And it's like you said, they've only tried going aggressive on A apps, and that's about it, apart from that one round where we saw Taz pushing up mid. And I would like to see, for instance, Taz, instead of posting up in a semi-aggressive position in VAPs and not really having any vision or scouting out what's going on, I would like to see him posted up in the position that Doja actually uses quite a bit, which is just a tiny few steps more forward, but you get such a, you know, a way better angle to catch NaVi off guard.
Well, right now, just, I mean, we're talking about, you know, Virtus Pro not being affected by their vacation time. And that was based, I think, off of some of the shots that we were seeing from them. It looked like they were hitting some good shots, so there wasn't any kind of rust in that area. But I guess in terms of reading what NaVi are doing and making the right calls for the right rotations, there's a little bit to be worked on here, I think.
Yeah. Although I wouldn't be too worried if I'm a VP fan, because they're probably going to have this in by the time G3 rolls around.
Oh yeah, definitely. Yeah, I mean, I think this is the first official match since they're back from vacation. So in a couple of days they will just have Buden been, you know, practicing pretty hard, and it's going to be a different team, no doubt about that. We've seen that plenty of times before, so I wouldn't be too worried either. Neo, I would be worried about, though. 1 HP in the corner, straight headshot will take him down, and it's going to be Snacks alone for the last round. So your prediction, if that's what it was, it comes true. 11-4, it's going to be it.
Yeah, it was more like a worrying omen, I guess, than anything else. It's not what I wanted to see, but it was the looming, I guess, looming possibility.
Exactly right. Snags goes down as the last guy. Starix with a good shot coming in, and that will be it. Good half is called. 11-4 for this first half of this game. If you're just joining us, then welcome to the stream. This is Room on Fire, and I'm Anders. With me is Vendetta, of course, and we're casting the SLTV Starseries Season 10 game between NaVi and virtus.pro, and so far, it has honestly looked a little bit one-sided.
It really has, and we also have to take into consideration the fact that VP were playing on the more favored side. Even though it's very slightly, but losing 11-4 is never a good sign when you're on even a slightly favored side.
Yeah, I guess that's true. I guess
if you look at Neo, everybody calling good half, and Neo's like, yeah, sure.
Not pleased at all. Well, look, yeah. All right. Going into the second half here, I really don't think there's anything that can save virtus.pro. I think for them, they're just thinking about that practice time, as you said.
Yeah, if anything, they have to win the pistol round. That's where it starts. And what's scary is the fact that I think NaVi is a way better CT-sided team than a T-sided team. And even so on Mirage, which is their best map, I think they're like a dominant CT side.
Good luck, have fun, is called by Taz, and we'll see. I do think you're right. I think NaVi is on this side even stronger, which is a scary thought. But then again, I do also think they're the best team in the world. I actually think they are a little bit better than virtus.pro on this map. Not by a huge margin, and I don't think that's what's making the difference here. I think it's more the lack of practice time for the Poles that's really kicking in. I think on a normal day when both teams are really up and firing, I think this map between the two would very often end up... Yeah, 16-14.
16-14, type. Yeah. It's a 16-14 to overtime kind of thing.
Yeah.
But yeah, and right now it seems like VP are making the right call here. Although NaVi are pretty gathered as a unit, they're still not in a position to actually stop a full-out A push from VP. Unless Starik lands some incredible shots.
Well, that is going to be unlikely, I think. Good as he is with a P2K. Okay, that's one. Goes for a second one, but he's going to come up short. But actually, that might have been just enough time here. Now the whole of NaVi is actually here. They are going to be able to get the bomb plant virtus.pro. But this is a pretty swift rotation coming out from the CT side. And they do have a kit as well. And not really many grenades. But if they can just catch one more player off here, I think they might be able to just overwhelm the bomb side. They're charging in already. Pasha's going to go down. Snags. Neo drops next. Bialy out of bullets almost. He's going to have to reload. Now it's a 2-on-2. 2-on-3, in fact. And it's going to be down to Snags here. Bomb already being defused. He can't really move up. And this is running out of time. And Seuss, you asked for incredible shots, Vendetta, and you got them. Two headshots from Seuss that really made that work.
Yeah, that was a really nice afterplant from NaVi. A really good retake. And, well, my Polish isn't that steady, I guess, but I'm assuming Bialy complimented NaVi on their retake.
It could be. That was certainly pretty impressive, because, I mean, once you're just one man in that bomb site, there is a lot of pressure on you to pick up those kills. Otherwise, it's really not going to be working out. So
yeah, and that initial frag from Starix, I think that really, as you said, I think that bought enough time for NaVi to actually make that rotation, because they were so gathered as a team that they really could just get into places really for a retake so fast that VP didn't really have a shot at getting into the afterplant positions they wanted.
So that will be it, 13-4, and obviously virtus.pro with the bomb plant are going to be able to buy this time. Try and see if they can make the score look a little bit better than it does right now, but I guess 16-4 isn't even out of the question here.
It really isn't. I think if VP loses this round, they're going to be in a big rut, really. And the way NaVi are playing right now, it doesn't seem like they're willing to show any sort of mercy.
I want to get it over with. I mean, they're going to be facing, I think, Mousesports next, if I'm not mistaken. So, yeah. So I guess we'll see how that game all pans out. It's a pretty interesting game coming up as well. Neo starting off the kill on Edwards. Seized goes down, and just as we say it, or we're about to call it here, NaVi, they crumble a little bit under the weight of the Polish team rushing up the middle. Guardian and Starix bringing it back, and actually, Pasher and Snacks are very low on health. I guess this could have been a NaVi round anyway, and Guardian is not quite done yet. He's going to hunt them down, see if he can catch anyone here towards the window room, but
gonna be I'm kind of hoping it goes for this, because they're going to have to eco the upcoming round either way, so why not? You have a big cushion, you know, try to be the hero.
Guardian makes a jump, so now they definitely know where he is, and that's obviously a big advantage. Would have been great if he could pick off one guy before that bomb went down, just making it a one-on-two. He's going to turn around and take down Snags, but with no kit and no grenades or anything, it's not really going to happen for a Guardian here. He is pretty good, and he's also close to the top of the board. And he actually sees that top fragment, but Guardian is at 16, so he's done a fine job already, but not going to be this time. Pasha will be surviving the bomb, of course, and it's going to be still a pretty expensive round for virtus.pro, but they do win it.
Yeah, and I think that's the way virtus.pro has to look at it at this point. You just have to be happy with what you get, and if you can get a round win regardless of how you get it, you'll take it.
Yeah, 19 rounds, and Guardian has just a 1 AK here. I don't know. I mean, if they had an AWP on him, I'd be more impressed. One AK, don't think it's going to be quite enough, and especially when he walks right into a shot like that and gets taken down to 14 HP.
Yeah, this is probably, or this should be a round for VP, but we've seen CZ75 work their magic before, but seems like VP wants nothing of it.
5-3, and Starix is going to go down. Seized, and Edward left. She said 75 is in hand. See if they can get anything done. Edward just jumping out into the middle. Bit of a crazy play coming out, and there were two people waiting for him. Seized, looking for a headshot long range. Not going to be picking it up, and it will be now 6-13. Let's see if they can go into the 20th round and change this NaVi, or if we're going to see some sort of insane comeback from virtus.pro. I mean, I don't know. I think 11-4 comeback on Mirage on the Terrorist side, that'd be something.
Definitely would. I'm not too optimistic about it, but I'd love to see virtus.pro grab a couple of rounds and, as you pointed out, kind of make the score a tiny bit prettier.
They start off well. Seized, fumbling around in the underpass. Not really sure what that was. Did he get flashed from the middle when he jumped down there?
I didn't see. He definitely did not get flashed from underpass, so who knows?
It looked like there was something strange going on there. Starix is going to be able to take, or is going to be able to go down there. Bailey takes him down with an AK. Sorry about that. And it's going to be Guardian, Seuss, and Edward left. 3-on-4 now. Good shot from Seuss, right? Going to be taking down Neo and Pasha. And now, well, 3-on-3. And NaVi, maybe they aren't going to give up so easily, especially not with Edward coming around from the back here. Bailey is right there. Edward has a shotgun. And he's actually running away from him. And the problem is, if Edward starts running to catch him, then Bailey is going to hear and the game will be up. He's turning around just as Edward comes through, and he's still going to go down. Nicely placed shotgun pellets to the face. Taz with a double spray down, and now Edward is going to get caught there. Great double from Taz, and also Snacks helping out. So there it is. But that could have very well been a round for NaVi, I think.
Yeah, I actually think it was a bit unfortunate that the smoke dissipated the at the point it did for Edward. I think he could have snuck up even closer to by Ali and maybe caught one more VP member off guard.
It would truly be something if he had done that, and if he had just, maybe even if he had just killed by Ali earlier on, which obviously he didn't really have a chance to, but that could have also made a difference. Seuss inside returns the kill. Now more people are coming, and Bailey runs and guns and takes him down. Now Guardian looking for the crossover here, but they know that he's going to be there, and they don't even want to play that game. Grenades galore just into the connector, taking him down almost. Oh.
Nice pickup from Edward there, denying the bomb plant. And, well, VP are going to get the bomb down regardless, but actually, I'm a bit surprised that NaVi are this defensively postured at this point. They could have definitely capitalized more on that pickoff than what they currently are.
No doubt about that. Oh, seized. We'll get the shot actually jumping over the box there. That's not at all bad. Snags is waiting, though. He turns around at the wrong time and is still going to be able to turn back again to get the kill, which leaves Guardian in a position where he can no longer win it. I actually thought Snags was going to go down, and that may have given the opening. That would have been Bialy left alone in a 1-on-3 almost, but it just doesn't work out that way. So I think just a split second actually decides that round.
Yeah, a really good job by Snags as well, though, to get those two frags. I think even if he just gets one, I think Navi are in a great position to actually finish that retake, because Bialy would have been in a really awkward situation too, where he would have to focus down whoever's defusing at the same time as having a VP member, or a Navi member gunning at him.
Guardian with the AWP in the middle. This is already a pretty impressive comeback from virtus.pro. They lost the first half 11-4, and right now we're looking at a 13-8 scoreline. Obviously can switch around pretty quickly if Navi pick up just a single round here. Obviously, the momentum is going to be quite different, but I mean, I'm already pretty pleased by just the fact that virtus.pro are trying to change their game a lot. But Guardian has an AWP. He's going to pick off Bialy straight away, and can he actually... Yeah, he's already rotating. Look at that. He takes the shot and instantly runs.
Yeah, it feels like Navi are aware of the fact that something's going on.
Guardian's picked up one more kill on Taz here, so now it's just Pasha and Neo left, and maybe we spoke too soon. Neo with a good pickoff, one on one here against Guardian inside the bombsite, AK versus AWP, and this is where Guardian is really good, but he's still going to go down, and that leaves Starix now in a one-on-one with Neo, who's already picked up a triple. He's looking for the bomb, he's got time for it as well. Starix is right down in the middle, and Neo comes up big. Quad kill from him, 6 HP survival, and he saves virtus.pro to fight another day.
Yeah, and right now that comeback is looking more and more feasible, because Navi has to eco, and even though Starks has quite a bit of a bank at this point, it's still going to come to this situation where Navi are going to have to eco after every buy round.
That is, I mean, we see it right now already with just pistols in their hands here. Seuss actually is going to get a kill on Taz, which is not at all bad. But up in the apartment, they already lost one person, and now Seuss is just going all crazy, picking up two kills and an AK, going for the second kill here, and Edward jumps across, and it's going to work. Edward will get the double kill, and now it's on Pasha, 1-on-2, and they're shooting through the bottom of that wood panel right there. Pasha is going to go down, and Navi, they couldn't pick up the rounds when they had rifles, but with pistols, they seem to do better.
What was that from Edward? That was just madness.
He jumped over.
And the fact that he gets that second kill with the last bullet, man. Well, that's kind of what CZ's does for you. Just a really solid display from Edward, and a great round coming out from Navi, and that has to be a knife in the heart for VP.
That is not fun at all, and if they lose this upcoming round, they can still make some sort of buy happen for what might be the last round, but it's going to be a little bit tricky here. It's definitely not over yet. I mean, if they've won this many rounds in a row, who says they can't keep going? But Navi have a really good hold on this A bomb site. They have four people, although they are rotating back a little bit. They should be able to get in here and actually maybe defend it. Not sure why they fell back so quickly. There's no bomb plant yet. Guardian is trying to look through the smoke somewhere. They're really worried about virtus.pro faking it out here, but they're not. They're fully committed. The Polish team is coming, and Navi can't stop them. Guardian trying to run away, but Neo, he's still close by. Edward's going to pick up the one kill, but Guardian actually just retreating all the way. And no bomb plant happening yet. Finally, it goes down, and Seast is going to pick up the one here. And now at 3-on-3, Guardian is going to come up from behind, but I think he's going to be there maybe a little bit too late, actually.
This still might be feasible if Edward's able to pick up Taz. I think Taz is pretty much the linchpin for VP's defense at this point.
Yeah, and he's almost down, but Guardian dies, seized with a kill. Now it's down to Pasha, 1-on-2 here, and he's in get right waiting. They spotted him out. Edward is going to not get the kill, but seized will. And I think that's just enough time. I think this is a last second defuse coming out. Navi win the round, and seized will pick up a triple kill, and that's a pretty impressive retake. Put it like that, it's down to the very last millisecond.
Yeah, I'm not really sure if Navi calculated it that way, but that was definitely a solid retake, and as I said, I think it was Edward picking off Taz in that situation that really made it possible for NaVi?
I don't know. I think maybe they were just talking about it and someone just said, no, we still have another 3 nanoseconds to wait. We'll push once.
It's like, I started my Omega stopwatch.
Yeah.
As they planned it. I got this, guys.
Exactly. Well, yeah, I was looking really convincing here. It's a 5-on-3. NaVi want to close it out. They don't want to see this comeback happen. And obviously, there's no overtime here. So best VODS Pro right now fighting for a draw. And now we are one round away from taking the map here. Taz peeking up. Good shot onto Starix. That's a solid headshot coming out. But is it going to be quite enough? They're still one man down. They have plenty of time, though. That's the one thing that's working for them here.
Yeah, that and the HP of NaVi is really iffy at best. I mean, three people at below 30 HP. That's one bullet from an AK.
Now look at Snax's position. See, he's just going to take down one. Snax is going to instantly run in and take him down. It's a very, very clever play. Now Guardian and Seuss are left here. 2-on-1 now as Snax is going to be alone. Bailey goes down. I was going to say it was going to be a 2-on-2. And Guardian peeks. Snax is ready for it. Seuss versus Snax. I mean, there's not a lot of time here. I think that's going to work against Snax.
Did he make... No, Seuss did not hear that. Well, okay, now the round is definitely in favor of Snax. He's going to be able to get into such a good afterplant position.
Yeah, this is really everything, isn't it? I mean, this is what it comes down to. If VODS Pro lose this, it's not going to work out well. Snax is going to put the bomb down, but he still has no clue where Seuss is from. Now he knows, and I think that's going to be the main difference here. 1-on-1, and one bullet on Seuss is going to be enough to take him down here. That's all it takes. And Seuss doesn't have... Actually, he has got some Molotovs here, so I wish he would try and use some of them. There it is. That's one corner checked, and now he should be able to realize that there's only one place Snax could be in. Snax just hiding. Seuss spending a lot of time. He's going to be walking up, and Snax is somehow just a complete ninja. Seuss has just no idea, and he's not even going to be allowed to exit the bomb site. So I'm a little bit surprised Seuss couldn't guess that it was going to be, because he already spotted him once, I think.
I think, who knows, maybe Seuss thought it was a figment of his imagination or something, because, yeah, he definitely should have figured out that, well, the only places he could be at this point, unless he's dodged me to ultimate perfection, has to be by forest. That's the only way, you know, that Seuss wouldn't have found it by that point. But kudos for Snax for actually, you know, keeping his calm and not moving an inch.
Yeah, it's gonna be VODS Pro now. Up against an eco round here, and they're doing a fine job just holding angles, making sure that NaVi, as they played pretty aggressively this round, just all got picked apart as they moved up. So we're looking at 11-15, and this is not quite over yet.
It really isn't, and VPR definitely playing a way better T side than what they showed on their CT side, and you can kind of feel that they're just doing things better than what they were doing on the CT side.
Yeah. Definitely.
They just
right.
Seem to react faster to everything that NaVi does, and they're just finding the right calls, really, to make.
I suppose there is an element of logic in this, because one of the things we were pointing out in the first half when VODS Pro were on the CT side is that some of the rounds they simply lost because they were in the wrong place at the wrong time. But when you're on the terrorist side, you're sort of the one who decides where
what's
the action...
right place.
Yeah, exactly, what's the right place. So maybe this is why it's working out a little bit better for them.
Yeah, that definitely might be. You don't have to... Well, I wouldn't say that you don't have to make reads as to what your opponent's doing, because obviously you don't want to run into stacks and whatnot, but yeah, you definitely have more freedom on the T side.
Neo with a good pickoff. Guardian in the middle. Oh, that grenade! He shoots Pasha before the grenade lands! It looked like he was going to actually shoot the grenade mid-air, which... I don't believe you can. Starix is going to be taken down by Ali, and right now we're in a 3-on-3, and this one could be for the game. NaVi have the health advantage right now, but if Starix goes down, none of that matters anymore. Now they're a whole man down. Guardian, oh, unscopes just as he sees that. And now that's definitely a missed opportunity.
Yeah, and this is, I think, Navi's best option at this point is to just run away with their rifles. Try again next round.
Yeah, that's what they're thinking too. I was going to say, if Snax made the crossover when Guardian was jumping and they could have made it a 2-on-2, I think they would have gone for it. But VODS Pro really aren't giving them a lot of chances here. And this is a very interesting game. I mean, we said 16-14. Now we might be ending up with a draw here at 15-15. Because now we just don't have the economy to keep fighting like this.
It is. Luckily for them, though, they do have that cushion of three rounds where they can kind of... regain their economy for that one final big push, or even two buys, really. So So they've got that going for them. What I'm really surprised about over is or what surprises me a lot is the fact that Navi are letting a bomb site pretty much being held by one guy at any given time. And it seems like virtus.pro are very aware of that, so they keep abusing it to no end.
Let's see, Seuss here close to the middle. CSAT 75 in hand. I'm not sure if they heard him running up there. But obviously Guardian and Seized are the two really important players here with the rifles. See if they can do anything. Guardian is sort of going to be able to scope down the middle. This Molotov maybe forcing someone out. He's certainly ready if they run out. They are going to be running out, but he misses the shot anyway. I think that was what he was planning, but it doesn't work out like he intended. Seuss is going to go down, and, well, virtus.pro. Is it going to be 13-15? Starix also dropping low.
This is a really awkward situation. I think Seized has the opportunity to really bring this back for Na'Vi right now if he just waits patiently.
Well, he's not so patient. Going to be walking in. There's one, but Neo was also there. So now the A bomb site's actually just lost. And again, Starix, I think if he can pick up a rifle and run away, but it's being guarded by Neo at the moment. Starix going to be walking in just with the right timing. Takes a kill, and now it's time to get away. He's going to jump down, but by Ali will not allow it. So it's going to be Guardian in a 1-on-3 here with 8 HP. And I think virtus.pro should just go hunting for him.
Yeah, definitely. They have the bank to really sustain the... or they don't really have an issue with losing guns at this point. So, yeah, they're going to be able to buy up. If they lose a round, it's game over anyway. So you can't really worry about your economy in that sense. So, yeah, I think definitely this is going to do a lot more damage to Na'Vi than it's going to do damage to VP if they lose a couple of weapons trying to take out Guardian.
Yeah, are they going to be able to find him? He's looking up there. If he fires this rifle, then... nah, right. Snacks is a little bit too far away to find the kill on him. He was sort of headed that direction. Right now, top scoring is actually Seized on the Na'Vi side with 29 kills. But on the other team, it's Snacks, Pasha, and Neo. So Taz and Bayern are a little bit lower on the scoreboard. But virtus.pro are embarking on a pretty cool comeback. Again, if you're just joining us, then welcome here. But reminder to everyone who didn't watch the first half that it finished 11-4 in favor of Na'Vi. They got 11 rounds on the terrorist side. And right now, we're looking at a 15-13 scoreline. If Na'Vi lose this round, they're going to be almost without any money. And they are pretty going to end up tying the game. That's what we've got. But great flash in. Na'Vi with the aggressive push. And that works out quite well. Now it's a 4-on-3. And virtus.pro, they've just lost some significant players there.
And this is going to be so hard for VP to pull off.
Yeah, Seuss flashed out, but now it's back into a 2-on-2. This auto sniper, though, might be just what the doctor ordered here. Seuss sees he's going to be actually smoked off. He's going to try and run through, picks off the one, and now Pasha in a 1-on-1 versus Edward. This game just can't get any closer at this point. And we'll see if Pasha can do it. He's already picked up a double. He's going to have to get the triple to try and win this round. He's actually got time, I think, to run all the way back if he wants to. He can double back to B. It's going to be close, but...
yeah, and unfortunately, I don't think he's thinking about going towards B. I just think he doesn't have any clue at all as to where Edward is. And that's worrying, because he's going to have to put down the bomb, and there's not really that many places you can plant and still have solid cover.
Look how close they dodge each other. No, none of them saw each other, but they could have definitely done that. Edward's going to be walking up, and that will be the game. It's decided based on more or less random chance about who peeks where. It's going to be all over. So there it is. Na'Vi win 16-13. But what a comeback from virtus.pro. That could have been sick. Now, the next game we have coming up, guys, is going to be another Na'Vi game. It will be Na'Vi versus Mousebolt. So don't go anywhere. We will be right back after a really quick commercial break. It's in about 5 minutes, 5-7 minutes. So, stay tuned to the channel. Remember to follow and subscribe. And we'll bring you more action in just a few seconds here. Yeah.